Welcome to the O'Connor Elder Law Channel. I'm your host, Melissa O'Connor. I'm a Florida-based elder law attorney. I do two things and I do them well, Medicaid planning and probate. Today I wanted to talk to you about a Medicaid planning strategy to address excess assets and spin down in an effort to apply for and qualify for Medicaid. And one of the strategies that we use is purchasing income-generating property. So you may realize or know by now that to qualify for Medicaid, you're only allowed to have, at this time, $2,000 in assets. So many people have more than $2,000 in assets. And so when we anticipate the need for Medicaid to help pay for long-term care needs, we evaluate different options for spending down one's money such that you will able to quickly qualify for Medicaid and get the medical care that you need. And one of the spin down opportunities would be to purchase an income generating property. If you have excess assets and you have enough to purchase an investment property, this may be the spin down mechanism for you. You may know that, at least in Florida, you're allowed to have your home. That doesn't count for Medicaid purposes as long as your house is valued at $585,000 or less. That's an exempt property. An income-generating property is also considered an exempt property. But what it does do is it creates an income stream. So by purchasing this investment property, you're able to have used this excess assets, invested it into a different type of asset, a non-liquid asset that Medicaid would deem as exempt, this income-generating property. However, the income-generating property now generates an income stream. You may realize that there's income limits for qualifying for Medicaid as well. However, we can address those income limits with a Miller Trust or a qualified income trust, and that additional income might also be part of your obligation share to the nursing home. But with that said, there are opportunities to certain things are exempt in the sense that all the taxes that you have to pay, your insurance for this investment property, you're also able to deduct improvements, the time that you're searching for tenants, and a 10% property management fee. These are all permissible deductions that would reduce your income stream as well, ideally creating a position that income stream may not be so great as to require one of those Miller Trusts or qualified income trusts. These are all calculations that we as elder law attorneys assist our clients with when they are evaluating whether or not this is a good investment for them and a good opportunity for them to spin down some of their assets. There's hassles involved with an income generating property. You have to deal with tenants. Other times families say they want to put a relative in that income generating property, and that's a great idea too, but know that you have to charge a market rent. It cannot be a love offering of a rent. Medicaid requires that it be a market value. It could be low market value, but it needs to be market value, your rental payment. But this is a opportunity that might work for certain families, and it's one that's worth exploring if you think that it's of interest to you. If this content has been helpful, I ask that you like and share with others. And as always, thank you for joining me.